Robert F. Kennedy is saying that the Democrats made a colossal mistake in how they handled Joe Biden stepping down. You guys got to check this out.
The Democrats have called themselves the party of democracy, but they ran the least Democratic primary ever. They skipped Iowa, New Hampshire, jumped straight to South Carolina. They killed all primary debates, booted RFK Jr. from the party because he posed a threat to Joe. Today, RFK Jr. held a press conference to tell Democrats, "I told you so."
A year ago, a little over a year ago, when I entered this race, I predicted that President Biden suffered from a degenerative condition that was not going to improve and that it would make it impossible for him to govern effectively. The reaction of the DNC to that obvious condition was to hide it from the American public and to use their power over the Democratic Party nomination process to make sure that nobody could compete with President Biden in a way that would expose his deficiencies. And as a result, we are where we are today, which is in a period of crisis.
RFK, whether you like it or not, is the best choice for the Democrats if they want to beat Donald Trump. I'm hoping the Democrats don't put him back on the ballot because I think we need Donald Trump back in the Oval Office. But could you imagine how popular RFK would be if he was an eloquent speaker? I'm telling you right now, I hate to say it because it sounds very vain, but in politics, this stuff matters.
Joins us now. So RFK, you ran the right way. You did what you were supposed to do. You're a Democrat. You primaried a Democrat incumbent, and they wouldn't let you. How did they jam you out of this thing? Because now look at what happened.
Yeah, I think it was a strategic mistake by the Democrats, Jesse. And you and I have talked about this before. But they got rid of, they changed the primary rules while we, you know, while we were running the primary. They changed 60 different rules to make it impossible for anybody to challenge Joe Biden. One of the things that you remember that they did to me is I'd been campaigning in New Hampshire, so they adopted a rule that said that any political candidate, any Democratic candidate who campaigns in New Hampshire, who steps foot into the state of New Hampshire, that all of their votes would go to the president, all of their delegates would go to the president instead of going to that. And then they shut down the Florida primary. They shut down a bunch of primaries and just said, "We're not running them. We already have our candidate." You know, a few weeks ago, President Biden was ridiculing Vladimir Putin, who won 88% of the vote in Russia. And he said, you know, that that was a fixed election, because President Putin had gotten rid, made sure no adversaries could challenge him, and also that he had fixed the press so the press wouldn't cover his adversaries. Well, the Democratic Party succeeded in doing the same thing. I haven't been allowed on any of the Democratic networks, ABC, NBC, CBS, CNN, as you know, Fox has been, has allowed me on, although Fox, people like you have allowed me to speak, you debate me, you give me a platform, even though you don't agree with things that I say. And I think that's the way the media is supposed to work. But
yeah, I mean,
the other media networks have forgotten
when you're
about
playing
that.
when you're playing with children, you just change the rules in the middle of the game and just kind of make it up as you go along. You can't do that when it comes to these high stakes. You know how things operate at conventions. There's been a long history of chicanery at these things. You've now have uncommitted delegates. Are we going to see bribery? Are we going to see quid pro quo? Are we going to see ambassadorships promised, donors greased? You're basically, this is a sprint to grease as many delegates by mid-August as possible.
Yeah, I think, you know, some of that is bound to happen. I think, you know, most of those delegates are kind of mom and pop people. They're committed to Biden. They committed originally to Biden. Is releasing them. I think a lot of them are probably idealistic people who want to see the Democratic nominee, or terrified of Donald Trump, who want to see the Democratic nominee succeed. But I don't, you know, the indicators now, Jesse, is that the party elites are not really going to let go of the process. And we'll see what happens. I, you know, the last time there's a lot of similarities between this election and what happened with my dad's election in 1968. There was a war going on at that time that was very controversial and it was very damaging to our country. There were protesters in the street. The convention was in Chicago. And my father, who was leading, got knocked out by an assassin's bullet, not by a resignation. You, in effect, had an open convention, but the DNC at that time tried to maintain control over it. They put their candidate in, which was Hubert Humphrey. There was the convention became riotous, and the riots shocked the American public, and they didn't want anything to do with the Democratic Party after that. And I think a lot of people in the Democratic Party probably should look back to what happened in 1968 and take some caution from allowing the party elites to continue to exercise control over their choices.
That would be good sage advice.
What a sad state of affairs that RFK is prohibited from going on CNN, ABC, MSNBC. Because this country was founded upon debate. If you don't agree with somebody, you can't just silence them and mute them off of any platform. No, you have to actually challenge them and say where they're going wrong. So the sheer fact that Fox News is the only network bringing on RFK, you have to applaud both RFK for having the guts to go on a combative platform, and also Fox News for allowing RFK to get his perspective out there. It just seems anything that the Democratic Party touches, whether it's the news networks, whether it's the way that they run a political campaign, everything is just toxic and it is completely contrary to the American way. Although I don't agree with a lot of RFK's policies, I respect the man for what he is because I know that he's not bought and paid for. I know that he's an honorable guy, just like his father and just like his uncle were. He actually wants what's best for America, he just sees a different way on how to get there. But when it comes down to what's going on right now with the Democratic Party, it's an absolute mess. It's absolutely chaos. I read that Barack Obama is not endorsing Kamala Harris and he wants an open convention. If that's the case, all hell is gonna break loose because these Democrats don't fight fair. But yeah, let me know how you think this is all gonna pan out down below. I'd love to hear that. What are your thoughts on RFK? But yeah, if you enjoyed this, make sure to smash that like, comment, subscribe, and wish you guys nothing but the best. Till next time.